Hey y'all, this is your old modeling buddy Brian here at the All Japan Model and Hobby Show here being held in the metropolis of Tokyo. And there's so much cool stuff here. We're going to take you around and show you all kinds of things for this HobbyLink TV presentation. And first we're going to start out at Beaver Corporation, the HobbyLink subsidiary Beaver Corporation, where we import all kinds of cool stuff into Japan. So let's check it out. Here we are checking out some cool new stuff from Freedom. Freedom Model Kits is a company out of Taiwan that's come out of the gates making all kinds of cool stuff. And we have here 148 scale F20A Tiger Shark and the What If Project F20N Tiger Shark. There never was a two-seater version of the F20, but there is a 148 scale now. The actual F20A was only a prototype. I think they made two or three or maybe four of them. Never was put into production, but it's one of those kind of neat legendary aircraft. Like, well, what if they'd have made it? How would it have changed history? All that kind of stuff. But we do have them in 148 scale from Freedom Model Works, and they're very detailed, nice recessed panel lines, rivet detail, all kinds of stuff there. You get boarding ladders for both aircraft, single for this one, double for that one. So yeah, really cool stuff. F-20A Tiger Shark, the legendary aircraft here in 48 scale. Now, these are both, this is on sale now. It just came in the other day. And the F-20N is coming soon. There's not a release date on that. And we just did get a release date on this other new item over here. This is a 1/700 scale French multi-purpose frigate, the Aquitaine. I'm not sure if that's correct pronunciation. And it's not written here anywhere except in Japanese. Aquitaine is what it says there. In 1/700 scale, this is one of these new generation semi-stealthy type missile frigates, and this is going to be coming out in October, so we should be seeing this in shops next month. Now we're checking out some stuff from our good friends at Wolfpack Design, a company out of Korea. Being from Korea, they also work a lot with Academy. Academy is a famous Korean plastic model company, and what we have here is the 148 scale kit from Academy of the MiG-29. And what Wolfpack does is they add all kinds of resin bits and some photo etch parts and things like that to make special versions. This is the MiG-29, the 9.12A Fulcrum A that as used in the Gulf War. I guess this is an Iraqi version, so who knows what happened to this particular aircraft in the Gulf War. Probably not a good ending, but I'm not sure. But it makes a great kit with the added parts from Wolfpack Design added to the already very nice 148 scale MiG-29 from Academy. So Academy plus Wolfpack Design equals great MiG-29. Some nice new releases in 1/72 scale from Wolfpack Design is, well, this is a previous release. This is a the T2C Buckeye test pilot school version. And this is a new release that's coming up. This is the Hellenic Air Force, the Greek Air Force version of the venerable T2CE Buckeye. I believe they use these in the Greek Air Force not only for training, but also for light attack and things like that, too. So it's the same great tooling with some new decals, and I don't think there are any new parts for this particular version, but the decals make all the difference. More great stuff coming in 148 scale from Wolfpack Design. We don't have a sale date on these yet, but the price for this one, 4,500 yen, this is going to be a new version of the T-38. See Talon, a U.S. Air Force version, and we see a new sprue here of some added parts, resin ejection seats, and some photo-etched parts. And then next to that, this is a Sanko Shupin. This is just a test product that they're putting out here. This is a T-38A Talon, early type, and it will also come with some newly tooled parts, as you see here, some injection-molded ejection seats and wheels, and I think that's the cover for the instrument panel. And so that's the price, and the release date on this one is not yet decided. So all kinds of good stuff coming from our friends at Wolfpack Design from Korea. Now, another Asian manufacturer, this time coming from China, mainland China, is a brand new company called Tiger Model. We had never heard of them until a couple months ago, and suddenly they presented us with these great new products that you see here. One of the samples that is built up here is a 1/35th scale AMX-10 RCR. This is a current armored vehicle used by the French Army. You see you got the built up here, and there's the box art there. And this is all coming out at the same time. There's also a 1/72 scale M1A2 SEP, Tusk II Abrams. That's coming out in 1/72 scale. Again, this is 35th. And another French military vehicle in 1/35th is the Panhard VBL, light armored vehicle. We don't have a sample for that one built up yet, but these are great kits. I actually built this one, and it went together like a dream. It's got a million parts, but everything fits like a like magic. What you see here, I put together in about 3 days total. It's no painting or anything, but the assembly was just a breeze. Now, an interesting thing for the first lot of these kits, do you see these cute little fighters here? Well, that's what they're called. They're the cute fighter series of aircraft here. They're snapped together kits. I also built all these. I spent about 20 minutes on each one of these. They go together real easy. We have a Ki-84 Hayate, Japanese aircraft. We have an F4U Corsair. Everybody loves a Corsair. And we have a BF-109E Messerschmitt over here. They're not really egg planes. Egg planes are pretty popular too. These are like super deformed or, you know, cute proportions, and they're called the cute fighter series. And for the first lot of these three kits that you see here, you'll get one of these for free. They are included in there. And then after that, these will be actual products for sale, but there's no release date or price set on those. But they're pretty cute, as you can see, the cute fighter series. Now we're taking a look at some great new stuff from Skunk Models Workshop out of Hong Kong. They make a lot of great aircraft stuff and some military stuff too, but we got some aircraft stuff here on display here. This is the recently released F-16 XL in 1/48 scale. Came out about a month or two ago and has been very popular kit. We've been selling a lot of these. This was the experimental cranked delta wing version of the venerable F-16 Fighting Falcon. And they put that big delta on there. It could carry tons of bombs, as you can see on the painted version here. Missiles, all kinds of good stuff. It's got a nice detailed cockpit, positionable canopy, and all that kind of stuff. So great kit. Now, a brand new product that's not even out yet is another aviation-related one. This is a Vickers Royal Navy tow tractor. They use this on the British aircraft carriers for pulling Yankee Harriers around on the deck. And it comes with the tractor itself, a bunch of crew figures, and the towing pole thing there for pulling the aircraft, and a little portable boarding ladder as well. And that's not even out yet. We expect that to come into the shop sometime either late this month or early next month. So some great stuff coming from Skunk Models Workshop. This is all 1/48 scale, by the way. Now here I am with another brand new maker that just exploded on the scene with their very first product, the Tiger One. Just, you know, right out of the box, they're throwing out an excellent Tiger One model kit in 1/35th scale. And this is Rye Field model from China. And this is their very first release. An excellent kit with working suspension, as you can see here, of an early 1943 North Africa Tunisian version of the venerable Tiger One heavy tank. So yeah, right out of the, one of our staff built this and said, again, building this was a dream, very easy to build. It's got individual link tracks. As again, you can see, it's got the working suspension. Lots of details everywhere. The only thing it doesn't have is an interior. Well, for this kit, it doesn't have an interior, but the brand new kit that they're coming out with as we come over here is this guy over here. This is the early version of the Tiger One, and it's going to have a full interior. And when I say full interior, I mean full interior. It's going to have engine parts, the cooling system parts, obviously the fighting compartment's got everything in there. Inside the turret, it's going to be packed. These are all the extra, it's essentially this basic kit with some different parts, but all these interior parts make all the difference. And this is coming out in about a month. This guy here is already out, but this new guy here is coming out shortly. And they're also selling these wonderful tracks separately too. So just right out of the box, Rye Field Models is just, you know, gangbusters going like crazy. Two new Tiger kits and some tracks. One of our very important partners here at Beaver Corporation is a company called Takom out of China. They make a wide variety of all kinds of very, very great armored kits. What we have here, start off with, is a trio of 1/35th scale chieftains. Modders have been screaming for new chieftains for years and years. You know, the only option was the ancient Tamiya kit, which is not bad, but it's ancient. Now we have all new tooling, all released at the same time, three different versions of the chieftain, the British Army chieftain here. We got the Mark V/P, you can see here. We've got the Mark 11, which actually has the thing up there, Mark 11 different version, and the Mark Chieftain Mark 10. All complete with amazing photo-etched parts to up the detail level even higher. The plastic itself is amazingly detailed. So really happy to see these. And they all came out at the same time. So Chieftain fans were just like, wow, which one do I buy? Well, it seems like they bought all three because we've been selling these like crazy all the time. So Chieftains, finally, we got some good Chieftains in 1/35th scale here. Moving over here, as we leave the chieftains, we've got the German 121, what is it, 12.8 centimeter flak 40, Zweiling, the twin flak there, the 12.8, 128 millimeter anti-aircraft cannons. As you can see in the upright position, trying to shoot down some B-17s or Lancasters or whatnot. The same gun that they put in the Jagdtiger and perhaps the E-100 and the Maus late in the war. Very powerful anti-aircraft gun. It's a lot of parts to this kit. Goes together very easy. And it also comes with photo etch parts here. All right, so we're going to leave these great guys and come down here. Go back in time a little farther. You know, these modern tanks and a World War II gun. We got some World War I stuff here. And earlier, we got the first over here. This is all 1/35 scale. We got the Škoda PA-2 Turtle. Yeah, Turtle's not too hard to figure out how they came up with this name. It's classified, it's a 2-in-1 kit, so you've got like this command version with the radio antenna, and then you've got the machine gun laden version here. So some World War I stuff here. And moving over here, oh, this is special. This is a special Beaver Corporation Japan limited edition version of the World War I Mark A Whippet tank. And it was a special Japanese limited version because Japan actually used these after the war. These were some of Japan's first tanks. I think they bought four of them and used them. And it comes with a special resin figure, special machine guns for the Japanese version, and some special decals as well. Now, for that same kit, you can also build the normal version, or the non-Japanese version of the Whippet with the different machine guns and some other different parts. So the Whippet, people have been looking for a new Whippet for a long time too, and bam, here we go. Other new great World War I tank news is the Mark V in 1/35 scale. 3-in-1 kit, you can build three versions, the male, the female, and the hermaphrodite. You guys can Wikipedia all that and find out what the difference between those are. It's got to do with the guns. So anyway, beautiful Mark V kit is also, I think that's actually on the boat. I think we're supposed to be getting these shipped in next week sometime. These other kits have just been recently released. But that guy's coming in soon. Oh, and the chieftains as well are also coming in on the same boat as the Mark V. And the last little guy over here is a 21-centimeter Morser. It's not Mrs. It's supposed to be Morser. It's actually more like a howitzer. That's a 2-in-1 kit, too. You can build it with the various different shields and things like that. I think this one made the transition between World War I and World War II. Another one of our great partners from China is Model Collect, and they specialize in 1/72 scale armor. They started off doing mainly modern Russian stuff, like T-72s, T-80s, T-90s, and stuff like that. But they've also started digging into the what-if German World War II armor. As you can see here, we've got the E-100, which was, I think they made one prototype, but this one's a little bit conjectural. This is the Ausführung B version, which never existed, in 1/72 scale. It's 1/72 scale, but this has a fully workable suspension, which is, I don't think we've seen that in 1/72 before. We got that. Coming down a little bit farther, we have the E-100 Stug assault tank version with no turret. It's just got a huge gun on there. We don't know what the size of that gun is supposed to be. 170 something? I'm not sure. But it's going to have PE, metal barrel, and Lincoln length tracks again, and also with a working suspension. How that works with the Lincoln length, I'm not sure, but it all works supposedly. And if we go all the way down there, we can see there's as I mentioned before, they specialize in modern Russian stuff, so we've got a T-80 BVD main battle tank coming as well. And if you take a glance over here, here's some finished models, some of their previous things, the TOS. Here's some more what-if German stuff. E-50 flak tank, E-75 with a 105mm gun, and some, what is this, a T-80B and a T-72B, more modern stuff. Flyhawk is another great company we carry. They're out of Chongqing in China. And actually, one of the new products is the light cruiser Chongqing, as you can see here. Originally, Flyhawk specialized in photo-etched parts. So one of the hallmarks of a lot of their kits is it comes with really nice photo-etched parts inside as well. And right now, they're specializing in 1/700 scale naval kits and 1/72 armor kits. So up top here, we have some brand new products that are coming. We don't even know release dates on some of these yet. Again, we got the aforementioned light cruiser Chongqing here in 700 scale. We've got the HMS Aurora, as it appeared in 1945. And we have the HMS Naiad, as it appeared in 1940. Actually, I think this guy's already on sale, but these other two guys are coming soon. Other previous amazing releases from Flyhawk, as we see down here, we've got the SMS Lutzo, as it appeared in 1916. The Derfflinger, also from 1916. Sister ships, you can see they're very similar. And the USS Ward, the destroyer, a VIX-class destroyer from 1941. kind of listing to the side there. I'll have to go in and fix that later, pump the bilge or whatever. And as we go down to the very bottom, we've got a couple of new items. Let's see here. Ah, this Panzer 1F is coming soon. And we've got a Panzer 2J is also coming soon. And we got these very popular Runo FT-17s that we've been selling a lot of. So very beautiful, highly detailed 172nd scale tanks. When you build these things, they're like the same detail level that you get, you expect in 135th scale, but it's in teeny tiny 172nd. So you get a lot of detail for your money. And finally, on the right here, we've got a selection of 170 or 1700 scale U-boats. We got a Type 7B. They're all Type 7Bs, but different versions of it. And this one kit actually comes with a little dry dock, so you can display it like that. And here we are with Meng. Looks like it's Meng, M-E-N-G. I would say Meng. I've been saying Meng for years, but we finally met the president, and it's actually Meng is the pronunciation. And they're one of our very, very important partners here at Beaver Corporation. We do a lot of great business with them because they make a lot of great products. Their newest product coming up now is the 9A52-2 Smirch, Russian long-range rocket launcher. This kit is just packed with all kinds of detail. It's got, as you can see here, it's got fully detailed engine, got a battery compartment there. The suspension is workable. The two front wheels are steerable. Two front sets of wheels are steerable, just like the real one. As you can see over here on this side, all the doors can be positioned, opened or closed. And the launch tubes, you can see the 12 rocket launch tubes, it can be elevated and traversed, just like the real deal there. It comes with, the tires are all vinyl, and it comes with mirror film for the rear view mirror, so you get an actual mirror-like finish on that. And of course it comes with a nice set of photo-etched metal parts to increase the detail even higher. So this is, do they have a parts count on this thing? Because it's got to be pretty high. Nope, doesn't say it on there. But yeah, this is the modern rocket launcher used by the Russians and probably some other Russian-related countries over there. But yeah, the Smirch Russian long-range rocket launcher. We don't have a price or a date. We do have a date. This is going to be coming out next month sometime, but we don't have a price on it yet. Yeah, so look out for the Smirch coming from Meng. And we'll go down a little bit here and see a couple more recent releases. We've got we'll start over here. This is the World War I tank, the A7V. This has been out for a couple months. But you know, with the anniversary of World War I happening recently, we've had just an explosion of all kinds of great World War I armor that we never had before. So we're happy to have that. That also has a pretty decently detailed interior. One of the most recent releases is the Leopard 2A4. One of the versions of the popular Leopard tank. And next to that, this just came out. This is the Soviet T-10 heavy tank. That's a kit that, again, there was only the ancient Tamiya version, but we're happy now to have a very highly detailed new version from Meng. And moving on to the right over here, we see some resin wheels, slightly different versions than the ones that come in the Smirch. That's also for the Smirch that we were just talking about. So they're going to offer a resin set for that. And another new product we don't have a sample of here, but we do have a panel of. This is some Israeli Defense Force infantry guys set with their really crazy hats. Gonna have to look into this and see what these hats are all about and on their helmets there, but it looks pretty cool. So great detail set there. Now we'll go down to the very bottom here, and we got some more interesting super deformed aircraft kits. Now these are all 4-engine bombers. And we've got America, Britain, and Germany represented here. We got the B-17G in a super cute, scrunchy version here. Next to that is the British Lancaster bomber, also cute and super scrunchy, and 4-engined. And we got this guy over here, the Heinkel 177, which you would say, hey, that's only 2 engines, but actually it had 4 engines. It had 2 engines per propeller on each side here. So it's actually technically a 4-engine bomber, but it only had 2 propellers on there. And that's also super cute and super scrunchy. So, and these are called these are Meng kids, we're calling him, because you want to get kids into, you know, heavy bombing as soon as possible. So we've got the Meng kids super scrunchy bomber kits here. We're very happy to have our good friend and partner Alex from Uschi Vanderossen here at the Beaver booth again this year. Hello. Demonstrating some great stuff. Hello, Alex.
Hello.
Hello, hello. So he's going to show you some great new stuff that he's got coming. What you got here?
Yeah, well, topic for this trade show here is, scenic display products, as we call it, the scenic display products. As some of you know, we have those prints here, and we now are in the process to combine these printed materials with three-dimensional objects. And if we have some 30 seconds, and I can show you how we set that up real quick. A little bit of preparation. There you saw the print right here, okay? And there we go. We got a little piece of wood here painted in red and white as like a corner section. Then we got another piece from the print right here. There's that one. And we treated that a little bit to make it three-dimensional, just pressing in those little lines in between them elements. Put it like that. Right here we go. Then we have the main segment. Put it right here. And here's in the artwork, there's a little bit of a dividing division line, something like that. So we should cut this out as well and use it to make it more three-dimensional, you know. Okay, like that. There we are already. Then we got a little tree right here. Put it here. Our models, right here. Right here. And we got a funky little box right here. How about that? Or maybe here. And there we are with a little diorama. We also can put some three-dimensional objects here. With this one, we can treat it with water and so on to make it blending into each other. But actually, we are here right in the, well, we are at the end result, or sorry, we are at the end of it, actually, right? We can do more. We got on the scope of delivery, there's more boxes, like toolboxes, like little wooden crates, you know. And right. if you wanted, you can combine it with like wood that I'm about to do right here to give it more three-dimensional appearance like that one. So that's actually the concept.
Excellent. So all these different textures and things are all on the...
Yes,
on
correct,
the
correct.
Right there.
Including a little bit of grass.
Little grass,
yeah. And also, and that's another one, we combine that. We're about to combine it with photo etch, as you can see right here. This is a little 70-second scale tank scene, or you also can put a 70-second scale aircraft on that. But here, for example, we got a drainage grill, and we got a hatch here, and we are in the process to develop kits, actually, including the print, grass, and little gravel littering material, foliage and that stuff, and photo-etched elements, so that you have everything in one little kit, we can call the kit, actually, to have a instant scenic base. I do not want to call the diorama, because there's Arsene Wolf, right? Real diorama artists. I don't want to mess with these guys, right? But we got a nice product that's helping us to display our work.
Right, well, it's beautiful stuff that you can put together something really nice in 30 seconds, as you showed right there.
Yeah, it's a 70-second, 48, and it will also come in a 30-second scale.
Excellent. So some great new stuff coming from Uschi van der Assen. Thanks a lot, Alex.
We try our best. Thank you, guys. Thanks for having me. Bye-bye.
Hey, Japanese armor fans. We're checking out some cool stuff at the Fine Molds booth, including an actual 1:1 scale replica of a Hago tank here. It says don't touch. I touched it. But anyway, it's got a cool thing, 1:1 scale here. Now we're going to move over here and check out a 1:72 scale model of a tank that never was. This was during World War II. In World War II, according to Germany and other places, bigger was always better. So Japan wanted to get in on that bandwagon and started to develop a 150-ton super tank. This is the OI. It never made it into production, obviously, but we got a little kit of it here. But keep in mind, this is 1:72 scale, so this is a monstrously huge tank, 150 tons. Even in 1:72 scale, it's about the same size as a 1/35 scale light tank. It's got very detailed tracks, suspension, even all the rivet detail under there. It's very nicely detailed. So you get it, see in here. This is actually painted up. Got the little Imperial Army star on there. Oh, and I just noticed it even has a little turret in the back. So you get those little final shots on the way out there. This is coming out in November, at the end of November. And you can, of course, get it at HLJ. So this is very cool. It's got the tracks are link and length. You can see got the sprue layout here. I mean, this is, just for all intents and purposes, it's basically the same as a 1/35 scale tank, except we got it in 1:72. All right, as most of you well know, the Gottes und Panzer craze has swept the globe in the last couple of years, and Fine Molds has certainly been on that bandwagon with all kinds of new cool girls and Panzer kits. And there's actually a new movie. A movie is coming out on the 21st of November, so there's going to be even further frenzy of girls and Panzer kits coming up. Now, what's really good news here is this is a 1/35 scale version of the Hago Japanese light tank, and this is an all-new tooling. In Japanese, they're saying here, this is the Masaka no Kanzen Shin Kanagara. It's like the oh my gosh, can you believe it? It's an all-new tool kit. because you have to ask the question. They had a very nice 135th scale Hago kit already that's been on sale for a while. And I was just talking to the staff here. That kit was released 20 years ago. I can't believe it's already been 20 years. And it was an older kit. It had some fit problems. It had belt style tracks. So they just said, you know what we're going to do? We're just going to make an all new tool version of the Hago, which is a rather popular light tank. Japanese light tank here. So we got all new tooling here. Some of the main points are it's got the Lincoln length tracks here when you got the you know, the sag built in over the return rollers here. That's always a very important thing when you're building your sagging track tanks. It's going to have some photo etched parts. And this is it's going to be a Grosse & Panzer version, so you get the cute decals here to mark it as it appears in the anime. So yeah, this is great news. All new tooled kit of the Hago Japanese light tank in conjunction with the Girls and Panzer movie coming out, and I'm sure they're going to have some regular Japanese military versions as well. Now if you come over here to the right a little bit, these are some new parts for some of their older kits. You know, Fine Molds did, it's not that old actually, maybe 10 years or so ago, the Type 97 Chihab, the 57mm turret, and the new turret version as it's called. And what we have here is just similar as with the Hago, we've got Lincoln length track sets with the sag built in. So you just slap those together on your tank and it looks like the real deal. And these also will have some Girls and Panzer decals and some photo etched parts. So we got an all new tool of the Hago, and we've got some extra added parts to update your older kits of the Chiha. Hasegawa has some great news for Japanese Imperial Navy fans. We're getting an all new tooled kit of in 1/450 scale of the Japanese aircraft carrier Shinano. And again, this is an all new tooling of it in 1/450 scale. The Shinano actually was built. It was built and it was actually sunk where it was built. I don't think it ever made it out of you historian and military history buffs can probably correct me, but I don't think it ever made it out of where it was built. It was sunk at its docks where it was tied up. They don't have any samples here yet, but they do have some video of the 3D CGI plans there, and then the blueprints for the sprue layouts all over here. Now this is coming out in December. Now Hasegawa's got another very interesting product here that kind of crosses over between like real-life construction modeling and SF. I'm seeing a lot of buzz on the overseas sci-fi boards, all the kit-bashing possibilities for this guy. This is the Hitachi Astaco Neo. It's a dual-armed, it's got dual robotic arms, multi-function construction machine thing. It's got like a cutter crimper arm on this side, and then your general grab and smash kind of arm over here. It's in 1/35th scale because it'll match up with a lot of different military armor. Some of the Bandai stuff is in 1/35th scale that they put out for a while there. You got the, you know, this is a built-up sample of it here, and we got the sprue layout here. So it's actually pretty darn cool. It's got a lot of hydraulic lines everywhere and vinyl. The tracks will also be vinyl, as you can see on this sprue here. And it comes with a cute a female driver figure. So whenever your queen aliens come up, you can pull your whole Ripley thing and tear it apart with your double dual robotic armed power loader type thingy here. A lot of movable parts on there. And again, this is in 1/35th scale, so all kinds of possibilities. So Hasegawa was ringing a lot of bells and pushing a lot of buttons with this cool new kit of the Astaco Neo from Hasegawa in 1/35th.
Hi everybody, Scott Hards here, and I'm a happy man. Why am I a happy man? Well, it's actually been a long, 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 long time since Hasegawa has released a 48th scale kit of a World War II aircraft. Now that's what got me into hobbying in the first place, was 48th scale World War II aircraft. And Hasegawa, among anybody, was the most famous company for producing those things, but they haven't had one in years, until 2015, yay. Now what have we got? We have the Nakajima E8 N1, which is the very unromantically named Reconnaissance Seaplane Type 95, parentheses, Dave. Perhaps better known as that tiny little biplane you had to build when you were building a Japanese cruiser or battleship model, because they're always back on the catapults at the rear end of the ship. So these are the aircraft that they would launch for reconnaissance purposes, and that would then land in the ocean next to the ships and get craned back onto the decks for their reconnaissance. So up until now, there's been a lot of people who have built this plane, maybe in 700 scale where it's about that big, or 350 scale where it's maybe a little bigger. We've never had a great 48 scale kit of this thing before. Now, no, it doesn't have guns on it, so a lot of people aren't interested in a reconnaissance aircraft. But I think, given its the big role it played in World War II and the fact that it's on just about every Japanese ship kit there is, that this is a very welcome offering, and I look forward to building one. In aircraft kits these days, all of the action seems to be in 32nd scale. Hasegawa, of course, knows that, and they've now announced a 32nd scale Zero Type 52. They're advertising it as the complete renewal. They're calling it a complete renewal because they actually already have a 32nd scale Zero Type 52 in their catalog. The problem is it's just so old and you know, soft, shall we say, these days, that they can't use any of the parts from it, or they'd rather not to. So they're going to go to a completely new tooling of the 052. Now, they've listed a retail price of 5,000 yen, which is only about $45 or so in U.S., so that suggests that it's not going to be like a crazy, mega-detailed kit that's going to take, you know, years to build. You can see the parts layout here, and they've got all of the visible parts are there. We've got full engine detail and everything. Plus a pretty good cockpit. They're even going to be including the main wing spar as a separate part here, and they've explained to us that not only is that, of course, accuracy, because you can see part of the main wing spar through the gear bays, but it will actually lend structural strength to the finished model as well, just like the real wing spar does. So it looks like we're going to have a nice, large-scale, brand-new Zero from Hasegawa coming in a few months here that a normal modeler is going to be able to actually complete and put on their shelf.
So Tamiya, 135th scale, mostly all new tooled M4A3E8 EZ8 Sherman. They never had one. Well, they had one in their catalog a million years ago, but they decided, hey, we don't have one in our catalog now, so let's make one. They had previously re-released the Tuska, or Aska, EZ8 Sherman in their boxing, but now they said, hey, we're going to make our own. And here it is. It's about 95% all new tooling. Only some of the road wheels and some of the suspension bits are carryovers from their previous Israeli Sherman. But it's great to see. Classic Tamiya detail, and I'm sure the fit and the ease of build is going to be tremendous. It's got the earlier T-66 style World War II type tracks. Comes with a nice figure. You see him crouching here in the cupola. This is modeled after the a type of tank that was seen in the European theater towards the end of the war, when this tank was deployed. And you can see down here, we got the sprue layout. It's got easy to assemble belt style tracks. Just wrap around, boom, you're done. Shermans don't have any noticeable sag on their tracks, so it really wouldn't benefit much from IndyLink saggable, super saggy tracks anyway. So you got that nice there. You've got clear parts for the periscopes. And everything you see here is all the all newly tooled parts. And there's just some of the road wheels and some of the suspension bits are again carried over. All new decal set. So yeah, it's great to see an all new tool kit of the EZ8 Sherman from Tamiya. Tamiya's brought back an oldie but a goodie. It's the M24 Chaffee. This is a venerable, I'm using that word a lot today, kit from Italeri. I think it was first introduced 20, maybe even 30 years ago, but the tooling holds up. And Tamiya's made it even more cool with the addition of, it got some link metal tracks here and a metal gun barrel and this little set of jerry cans and drum cans, and also all these little things you see here with the figure and on-vehicle materials there. So yeah, so they've really powered up the old but still very very cool M24 Chaffee. Again, it's the parts from Italeri with some extra added stuff from Tamiya, making it all new for 2015. Okay, the all-new Mazda Roadster, new for 2015. The real car, and also Tamiya is the first guys out of the gate with a kit in 1/24th scale of the Mazda Roadster. What's this called in the States? Miata? Something like that? Overseas, not just the States? Anyway, it's the Roadster here in Japan, and we got it in great 1/24th scale. We've got a built-up kit of it here, but we don't have any runners or sprues, so I don't... When is this actually coming out? This is coming out in... We'll have to look that up later because I can't find it. We got some stuff here. Cool thing here, I just learned talking to some staff, is the lovely lady figure here you see who will hold the steering wheel and operate the vehicle is actually a Tamiya staff member. I've never met her personally, but she makes a nice figure to drive the Mazda Roadster. Well, here's another great older Tamiya kit that's had a lot of new parts added to it to make it even better. This is the Tyrrell 003 Formula One car as it appeared in the 1971 Monaco Grand Prix. If you're looking down here, only the gray parts. The gray parts are from the original release. All the blue parts are all new. It's all new tool parts for the body. A lot of the parts in there. And as you can see down here, they're all on the runner here. Got some of the engine parts, a lot of the body parts. And this time it'll come with a photo etch set and all new decals. And this is coming out in November. Aoshima's got another great new 1/12 scale bike in their naked bike series. This is a CB404. This was a great machine from the 1970s. It's got as you can see, all kinds of parts laid out here. Has a 408cc engine. That seems like an odd number. I don't know much about bikes, but 408cc. And that was actually reproduced through 3D scanning. So Aoshima always has a great detail and great fit, and we got another great bike in their naked bike series in 1/12 scale, the CB404. Okay, Aoshima has been very famous for all kinds of cool Lamborghini type stuff, and what we got here is some pre-painted parts and on the Aventador LP704. As you can see, it's very popular with all the fans here as this gentleman takes a picture. But you got pre-painted interior parts, pre-painted brake calipers, all this stuff like that. So all you got to do is slap it together. Don't worry about painting, and you get yourself a nice Aventador ready to go. Speaking of Lamborghini, here's an all-new tooled model here. We only got some rough, fast prototype type stuff here. The Lamborghini Sesto Elemento. You can see they got an exploded parts thing over there. Looks like it's got fantastic engine detail here. You can remove the rear panel and the front panel and see the engine in the rear, the suspension up front. And then they got the proposed parts layout set up here. So the Sesto Elemento. This is, of course, all new tooling. And actually, it says this is the planned parts layout. So it's still in the developmental stage. But usually when they get this far, this is pretty much what you're going to get in the box. Aoshima's been producing Thunderbirds kits for a long time, and we have right here Thunderbird 4, the seagoing one. This is was operated by one of the Tracy boys. I can't remember who it is, but it's an all-new tooled kit. It's in 1/48 scale. It comes with all kinds of cool parts, missiles, little different grasping arms, and a little cool undersea diorama base. Reminds me of the old Aurora kits from the 60s that I love. We got the parts layout here. And so it's kind of built into a very nice scale model. So you Jerry Anderson fans, Thunderbird fans out there, all new toolkit of the seagoing Thunderbird 4 in 1/48 scale. So I wonder if we're going to get a 1/48 scale Thunderbird 2 to put this boy in at some point. Probably not, but there you go. Aoshima's got an all new toolkit of in 1/700 scale waterline model of the U.S. Navy aircraft carrier Wasp and the Japanese submarine that sunk it. The Japanese submarine E-19 as it's called. So you can see them over here. Waterline kit of the carrier, and the submarine actually builds into a full hull or a waterline model. So you can see the hunter and the hunted, as it were, there. We got the parts laid out here, the Wasp, and you can see the little submarine over there. And actually a special set of photo etch parts just for this kit will also be coming out at the same time. This is all coming out next month, in October. So yeah, 1/700 scale Wasp and its hunter, the E-19, in 1/700 scale from Aoshima.